Hello dear learners, good morning and welcome to my online class. This is Kamrul Islam, English teacher, Saad Madrasah High School, Hatadari, Chattogram. My today's topic is tech question for the students of class 10 and especially for the candidates of the SSC exam. You know tech question is a very easy grammatical item from where you can obtain 5 marks, 4 marks. First of all, what is a trick question? A trick question is a short question after a statement. So, trick question can be done in two ways, from the positive short statement and from the negative statement. Have a look. For the positive statement, in that equation we have to use negative integrative. It is called negative tag. It is called negative tag. And if the statement is negative, then integrative in the tag, integrative form is used. It is called positive tag. If we find any positive statement, we have to do negative integrative in the tag. It is called negative tag. And if we see negative statement, we have to do only integrative, and it is called positive tag. So for the negative tag or negative integrative, we must learn these things. These things must be learned. Look at the board. If you see am not, if you see am in the positive statement, then in the tag it will be ain't or aren't for am or am not. Is not, isn't, are not, aren't, was not, wasn't, are not, aren't, have not, haven't, has not, hasn't, had not, hadn't, do not, don't, does not, doesn't, did not, didn't, shall not, notice please, shall not, shan't. You must remember it. Shall not will be shan't. Will not will be won't. It also, these two things must be remembered. Shall not, shan't, will not, won't. Should not, shouldn't, would not, wouldn't, cannot, can't, could not, couldn't, may not, mayn't, might not, mightn't, must not, mustn't. These contractual forms must be used in the tag if the sentence is positive. So, you will get two types of statements, positive and negative. If the basic thing of, about tag question is, if the statement is positive, then the tag form will be negative. We can say negative interrogative. Salma sings a song is a positive statement, that's why doesn't she in the tag. Doesn't she? The boys play cricket is also a positive statement. That's why negative integrative form, don't they? We can say negative form and negative tag. And now, Salma does not dance. This is a negative statement. That's why positive tag, that is only integrative in the tag. Does she? The boys do not play football, do they? In this way, we shall learn English is a positive statement. That's why shan't we? He will not learn English. It's a negative statement. That's why will he? And now, the baby is crying for milk. Isn't it? Here, the auxiliary verb is, that's why, isn't it? Now, you have to remember or notice one thing, that we cannot use noun or same subject, same noun in the tag. If the noun is, if the subject is a noun or name, then it must be changed into pronoun. The subject here, Salma is a subject, but in the tag, she has been used. We cannot use Salma in the tag. She has been used in the tag in praise of Salma. Again, there has been used in praise of the boys. That means if the subject are nouns, then their pronouns will be used in the tag. But here another thing is noticeable. The baby is crying for milk, isn't it? We have used here it for baby because baby can be a boy, again it can be a girl, but we are not sure about its gender. That's when we cannot be sure about the subject's gender or identity, we must use it. In this way, we can do all tag questions very easily. We can notice here from the notice here that comma has been used after the statement and note of question mark. Question mark has been used in the tag. So these are very compulsory things. Comma must be used after the statement and question mark must be used in the tag. This is compulsory. So you must remember these things, and in this way you can get full marks from tag questions. And now I am going to discuss other things about the tag. Look at the board. If we see everything something anything nothing, we have to use it as a pronoun. Everything something anything nothing. For thing, we have to use it as a pronoun. Suppose nothing, nothing is impossible. Is it? Because nothing is a negative word, that's why is it, not is not used here. Everything was fine. Everything was fine. Wasn't it? Because everything is, this statement is positive and this statement is negative, that's why is it and not has been omitted. Everything was fine is a positive statement, that's why wasn't it. So you must remember something, everything, anything, nothing. For such type of subject, it must be used as pronoun. Now everybody everyone somebody someone anybody anyone, nobody, no one, none, equal to they. For all these indefinite pronoun, we have to use they. This thing must be remembered. If you see everybody, everyone, somebody, someone, anybody, anyone as subject, nobody, no one, none, then you must use they in the tag as subject for these words, for any of these words, like somebody, someone is coming. Someone is coming. Aren't they? You can ask why here are is used instead of is. Is used with someone, but as we use they for someone, so the auxiliary verb must be changed. For they, are will be the appropriate. That's why aren't they. Everyone or everybody hates a liar, don't they? It's a positive statement, that's why don't they. But every mother loves her child, doesn't she? Because after every, if we see one and body, then we will use the, but after every, if we see any noun, then we have to use the pronoun according to the gender. Here mother is feminine, that's why she has been used here. But every teacher loves his students, don't they? You must be confused about this. Every teacher, subject is every teacher, but we have used they. Why? Because teacher can be feminine or can be a masculine. We don't know about the gender of the teacher. That's why we have to use they. After every, if we see common noun, then we must use they instead of singular pronoun. Okay? These things must be remembered. Everybody, everyone, somebody, someone, anybody, anyone, nobody, no one, none. If you see this type of indefinite pronoun as subjects, you must use they in the tag questions. Now, never, nobody, no one, none, scarcely, neither, hardly, seldom, few, little, rarely, rarely, nothing. All this was, etc. All these words are considered negative. Never, nobody, no one, none, scarcely, neither, hardly, seldom, few, little, rarely, nothing, etc. All these words are considered negatives. That's why we must be very careful to use tag question with any of this word, because not will not be used in the tag. Suppose he never tells a lie is a negative sentence because of never, so we cannot use not here. Does he, in this way, nobody, nobody went there. Tag will be did they. He seldom smokes. Does he? In this way, a barking dog seldom bites. Does it? So, if we see this negative words in the statement, then the statement will be negative and the tag will be positive. Tag will be done in the positive tag. That is, only interrogative will be used in the tag without not. Please, these things are very important, because students cannot understand about the statement. Some of the students think that the statement is positive and they use not in the tag, and that's in this way they make mistakes. Okay, now we should remember that they are and one will not be changed in the tag, in the tag question. That is, if we see any sentence, there was a king, wasn't there. There lived an old man, didn't there. One should do one's duty, shouldn't one. That is, if the subject is there or one, and in the tag, there and one will be used as pronoun. There will be no change. I'm sorry, the recitation is gone. Okay, no problem. I will continue my class. If you see क्रोस और इन्फिनिटिव और जिरान एज सब्जेक्ट्स देन वी मस्ट यूज इट इफ वी सी If we see cross or infinitive or gerund at the beginning of the sentence, at the beginning of the sentence or any exclamatory sentence without subject and verb, we have to use it in the track, in the track question. Suppose we know that that is that he is honest is known to all. In that tag, isn't it? Tag will be isn't it? In order to tell a lie, is a great sin. Isn't it? Isn't it? Telling lies or swimming is a good exercise. Isn't it? In this way, what a pity, isn't it? What a news, isn't it? In this way, if we see close, infinitive, gerund at the beginning of the sentence and subject, then in the tag, it will be used. We can also use it for the abstract noun, like the father for the abstract noun. It is also used, like the father rose in him, the mother rose in her. Isn't it? isn't it. Our students often make mistakes by because they think that the father and the mother will be the subject, and they think that for father he will be used here, isn't he, and here for the second sentence, instead of mother, there will be she, isn't she. But they are wrong, because the father means fatherhood here, and the mother, the father and the mother have been used here as abstract noun, fatherhood or motherhood. So they must use it for the father and the mother, not he or she. Now look at the board. These things are also very important for tech questions. With, along with, together with, as well as, accompanied by, and not, etc. Look at the blackboard, please. With, along with, together with, as well as, accompanied by, and not. If you see these words, conjunctions, then he along with his sister came here. We have to use pronoun for the first subject. He is the first subject here, and with his sister is the second subject. But in the tag, we must use pronoun for the first subject if the subjects are along with or are accompanied with these words. So he along with his sister came here will be did he. Mother along with her, or as well as mother as well as her children. Mother, we can use here along with, instead of along with, mother as well as her children died in the accident. So didn't she. She has been used as pronoun for the first subject. In this way, all subjects before these words will be the pronoun of all subjects before these words will be in the tag questions. Here the different thing, if we see or nor, then we have to use pronoun in the tag for the second subjects. Either Karim is a subject, or his friends are also subject. Karim first subject and his friends are the second subjects. So we use pronoun for the second subjects if we see or not in the sentences. So not his friends did it, didn't they. Salma, nor her brother, has passed the exam. Second subject here, her brother, so he will be used as pronoun. Has he. nor is a negative word. That's why not is has not been used here. Salma nor her brother has passed exam. Second subject, as we have already said that, I have already said that if you see or not, then second subject will be considered. And for second subject, her brother, he has been used here as pronoun. Now, some of us, some of you, some of them, all of them, etc. If you see any sentence in this way, any subject of after of, if you see us, we have to use we. If we see you, you will not be changed. For them, they will be used. That means for after of, subject of the object will be used in the text. Some of us have got the prizes, haven't. As for us, we have to use we, haven't we? If we see them, they will be used. If we see us, we will be used. Some of them passed the exam, didn't they? Didn't they? And all of us will pass the exam, won't we? Won't we? So you must remember, if you see or not in the sentence, in the statement, you must take the second subject as main thing. That means pronoun of the second subject will be used in the text. You must remember it. And if you see with, along with, together with, as well as a companion, then first subject of the pronoun of the first subject will be in the text. When for or and not, second subject of the pronoun will be used in the text. And some of us, some of you, some of them, if you see this, then you have to use subject of the object after of, subject of the object after of. If here as was object, then that's why we have used we. And in the second subject, some of them object have been used here, for that's why they have been used in the text. And last of all of us, us have been used here after of, and then we have used we in the as pronoun in the text. So these things are very important about text questions. Look at the blackboard. I have also written some more things, very important things regarding text questions. Please look at the board. For plural common noun, they will be used in the text question. For plural common noun like the pious, the virtuous, the brave, the rich, the poor, they are called plural common noun. And for such plural common noun, they will be used in the text. Look at the examples. The pious, look at these examples. The pious are happy. And text will be aren't they? The brave deserve the fear, don't they? Because they are plural common noun, so they are used in the tag as pronouns. This is the picture. This is also very important. This is the picture, isn't it? Look at this verse, this, for this and that, it will be used as pronoun, and for this plural, these and those, they are plurals of these two words, they will be used. So this is the picture, isn't it? Isn't it? These are the mangoes, aren't they? So if we see plural common noun, we will use they as pronoun, and if we see this and that, we will use it, and for this and that, plural for the plural form of this and that, they will be used in the tag questions. But this is the girl. Very interesting. This is the girl. Isn't she? We cannot use it because we already know that this is a girl. So for person, we cannot use it. Now, if you see had better, then hadn't will be used in the tag. If you see would rather, wouldn't will be used. If you see used, then didn't will be used in the tag. You had better. For examples, you had better resign the post, hadn't you, he would rather buy it, wouldn't he, I used to draw pictures, didn't I, because for used to, didn't will be used, I'd help the poor, wouldn't I, and I'd help the poor, hadn't I. Now the difference, here, I was to be D, it means I'd. I was to be D, I'd. It means here would, that's why wouldn't has been used here. How can we understand that it is would? Because after I'd help is the present form of the verb one, and that's why we must remember that it's not had, it must be would. Accordingly, wouldn't has been used here, and after I'd, it is had here, because after I have studied it, verb 3 has been used here, and we know that verb 3 is always used after had, have, has, so it cannot be would here, that's why hadn't I has been used. So if we see any apostrophe ID, and then after bar present form, we must consider that it must be would. And if you see I have to be D and then bar 3, we must remember that it must be had, not would. And that's why hadn't I. These things are very, very important about tag questions. I hope all you have understood these things. Now, I am writing a question of imperative sentences. Imperative sentence. We know that imperative sentences are of several kinds. First, draw the picture. This imperative sentence starts with verb at the beginning, and then don't draw. Don't is used at the beginning, and let her draw the picture, let us draw the picture. So if you see imperative word, imperative sentence starting with verb, we do it won't you don't draw the picture. If you see don't, then will you. And let her draw the picture, let me, let him, let them, for all let her, let me, let them, let him, for all these sentences will be will you will be used in the tag. If we see any sentence starting with let, let me, let her, let them, then we will do it with you in the tag. But for let us, it's fixed. For let us, we must use shall we. So the main most important thing is that if we see any statement with let us, it will be in the tag. Shall we will be used every time. Shall we? For every time we must use shall we for let's or let us. But instead of us, if we see other objects after let, then we will use will you. Please remember this thing. If we see other objects like him, her, them, you, then after let, then we will use will you in the tag. But when we see let us or let's, then we must use shall we. And if you see any imperative sentence started with verb present, we will use won't you, considering that it is positive. And if we see don't at the beginning of the imperative sentence, we will use will you. Can you is also possible. Would you is also possible. Will you is here. Will you, can you is also possible. But the easy rule is that if you see any sentence, we must positive sentence for positive imperative sentence, we will use won't you. For negative imperative sentence, we will use will you. For let and other objects except us, we will use will you. For let us, we will use shall we. In this way, the question of imperative sentence must be done regarding imperative sentence. Okay. Dear learners, now look at the board. For complex sentence, if you see any complex sentence in the statement, we have to track the main clause of the complex sentence, main clause. Suppose if we if you study attentively, you will pass the exam. Won't you? It's a complex sentence, so the main clause of this complex sentence is you will pass the exam, and we did the tag won't you. And for for compound sentence, again, if we see any compound sentence, then we will do the tag question in the last clause or second clause. They played well, but they could not win the match. The second clause is, or the last clause is, they could not win the match. Could they? Could they? So, if you see any complex sentence, it will be done in this way about tag. And they played well for compound sentence. Also, the second sentence will be in the tag, could they. That is a main clause, main sentence of the compound sentence, and the second sentence of the compound sentence we consider before we do tag. Now, sometimes we see that I plus think, hope, see, know. Suppose we hope he will pass the exam. I think he is good. We know that he is honest. In this way, we can see a sentence with I plus think, hope, see, know. And if we see that, we have to do the last clause. That is, after think, hope, see, know, the clause we will take after think, hope, see, know. So we hope is the first sentence. He will pass the exam. He will pass. Second sentence will be taken here. Won't he? Will be considered. Won't he? And I think he is good. Isn't he? Isn't he? In this way, tag will be done. Now, last of all, sometimes we see good morning, good night, good evening, happy birthday. If we see such words in the tag questions, we must use don't I, because good morning means I wish good morning. Happy birthday means I wish happy birthday. Wish is silent here. So if we see good night, good evening, goodbye, good morning, happy birthday, we must use don't I. I have discussed, I have tried to discuss all the things you can see in tag questions, details, and I have explained everything so that you can understand easily. And I hope all you have enjoyed the class. Thank you for joining me.